Tara.
Yes.
Got a joke for you.
All right.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Girls aren't good at science. It's not a joke, because girls are good at science.
That's the truth, not a joke.
Yeah. So Tara Long, host of Rev 3 Games and Hard Science, thanks so much for coming on.
Of course, thanks for having me.
You are the perfect expert to talk about girls and women in science because you're a woman and you do science.
Yes.
First off, I just wanted to ask you, what got you interested in science to begin with?
I went to a math and science and engineering high school. We had a lot of really good professors. A lot of them were ex-industry people or PhDs who sort of retired at age 50, decided that they wanted to teach high school because they really love, you know, math and science, and they wanted to get kids interested in that, and by God, it worked.
It worked! Was there a specific science or engineering discipline that you liked the most?
Probably calculus. I love calculus. Oh. I majored in math in college.
In terms of statistics of women who pursue math, obviously there are a lot more men who tend to major in math. What was it like for you in college?
I was usually pretty outnumbered by men. Nobody really treated me any differently in those classes. I quite enjoyed it, and I stuck with it for 4 years, so that's something, I guess.
Pretty cool to be a trailblazer.
Exactly. Sure, I'll take that.
Yeah. This gender gap that we hear a lot about in terms of women and girls in science, tech, engineering, and math. A lot of times the conversation circles around to this debate over whether women are inherently not good at science or whether we are more nurtured or socialized to believe that we are not.
I think everybody is capable of doing math and science. I certainly don't think there's a difference between the male brain and the female brain when it comes to stuff like that. A lot of it is having teachers who inspire you. A lot of kids these days go into high school and they think, I'm not good at math, like before they even really try it, and they sort of have this idea that they are just terrible at it, when in fact, it just takes practice and passion.
I was actually reading a blog post written by a math teacher a couple weeks ago who was talking about how, with math especially, this idea that you need to be good at it really fast is a mistake that a lot of kids make. Math can be kind of a slow discipline where it's going to take you a long time. Maybe science is the same way, where maybe we believe that we aren't as good at it because we don't pick it up immediately, but you're not really supposed to pick it up immediately.
Math is one of those things that you have to keep practicing in order to become good at it. And if you don't have that good foundation of education for it, it's really hard to pick it up later in life. My boyfriend is a programmer, but he could not simplify a fraction to save his life. And it's because he never cared about that stuff in middle school. He never had a teacher that inspired him. And that just sort of carried through to the rest of his life. So even though math is actually a very vital part of his job, he's not in that mindset to really appreciate it the way that a lot of people are.
What do you think is one way maybe to engage more girls in science? Is it the whole route that I see a lot of, saying things like, well, hey girls, guess what? Your makeup was made by a chemist.
No. I don't think you have to specifically cater math and science to sort of a girly way in order to get people interested in it, especially girls. That's just totally missing the point, you know? I think about space. Space is so cool.
Space is
and it
really
has nothing
cool to
do with like girly stuff or anything like that. When I was a kid, I was really into space. I sought out information on that myself. And it's just something that you have to have a passion for. I think teachers are absolutely the number one way to instill that love in girls from a very young age.
Tara, listen, you're doing your part by being the female co-host of Hard Science.
I'm trying.
You're showing men, women, girls, boys that science is a lot of fun.
My co-host Anthony and I, we have a lot of fun just trying to get people excited about the stuff that we are excited about. Going pretty well, I think.
Yeah.
We're 3 episodes in and we've got a few subscribers and a lot of good praise. So hopefully I can keep that up and get more people into it.
To close things out, what so far has been the hardest of Hard Science?
We built a hovercraft for our first episode. It was an easy setup, but it's hard to achieve the results that you wanted to achieve. We tried to ride it in the water, well, Anthony did, against my judgment, and it didn't work quite so well. Trial and error, that's what science is all about.
Exactly. Tara, thanks so much for coming on.
Of course, I really appreciate it. Thank you guys for having me.
And let people know where else they can find you.
YouTube.com/hardscienceshow, and I also host some gaming stuff as well at YouTube.com/rev3games.
If you are a lady watching and you're into science, tech, engineering, or math, let us know below what kind of sciencey stuff gets your brain going. Comment, and don't forget to subscribe.